It may look like the opening of a Bond movie, but this helicopter ride is the quickest way to get to the location of this next install. And just as in every Bond movie, there's a high-tech aspect to the story here, thanks to Victron Energy.
Installation is at 2,200 meters above the sea level. There is no street towards this installation, but we have to transport everything via helicopter. Therefore, it's very important that you don't forget anything.
We're in the spectacular Berchtesgaden National Park at the Austrian border with Germany. And this idyllic alpine refuge, or Hütte, serves as a welcome shelter for thousands of hikers each year, providing not only food and lodging, but protection from the ever-changing mountain weather.
The most people come here to chill. We have the wonderful mountains and they are happy. They must go 7-8 hours and then they are very happy to stay here, but they come every year.
The 10 staff members clean, cook and prepare the rooms for guests, and some are even trained in first aid in case hikers arrive injured. Depending on the route taken, it can take between 5 and 7 hours for hikers to get here.
Yeah, there are many people who take this way and not stays here. When they hurt the knees, then you call an ambulance. Then there comes the helicopter once a week.
Opening in 1929, to cater to the boom in mountaineering in both Austria and Germany, the Ingolstädter Haus enjoys commanding views of the Steinernes Meer, or Stony Sea Plateau. But after nearly 100 years of alpine hospitality, an upgrade is needed to bring the hotel's energy system into the 21st century. And Victron Energy installers have made it up the mountain to make sure the job's done right. The booking system for the hotel goes live every January and quickly gets fully booked for the summer season. Even with a total capacity of 116 beds per night, running a busy hotel at 2,119 meters above sea level, with multiple rooms to heat and a busy appliance-heavy kitchen, presents Michael with significant energy challenges, too many it appears, for the current setup to cope with. There are two generators on site, one as a backup, and after an initial start and warm-up using diesel, the generator then switches to rapeseed oil. When the generator is no longer required, diesel is flushed through the pipes, ready for the next usage. There are strict regulations within the national park regarding the use of diesel. Although you'd think this was due to the fumes from the generators polluting the atmosphere, the park considers a far more dangerous issue, and that is the pollution of the watercourses, should a diesel delivery truck have an accident en route to a location. A key consideration here is water supply. The Ingolstädter Haus relies on meltwater harvesting and treatment on site for all drinking, washing and sewage requirements. In the basement of the main building there is a water treatment room. The meltwater is passed through several filters and an ultraviolet tube to make it potable. Hot water for the building is stored in a large insulated tank in the basement. This is heated using an electric immersion heater. Water comes at a premium, so guests need to use tokens to get an allotted time for a shower, reducing waste. The waste from toilets, sinks and showers is filtered in a separate industrial-scale treatment building. The treatment is just the same as what's done in the local town, albeit on a smaller scale. Although this generator has been used quite extensively due to the degrading lead-acid battery bank, Michael and the club hope the usage will drastically reduce with the new system installed.
The old batteries are 20 years old and they are dead. And so we get a new one. It's much easier for me because I don't need so much raps oil and the generator only for the warm water. But when we have 100 people, then you need also a generator. But for me, it's cheaper to make the hut with the batteries.
The club that operates the houses turned to a local installer to assess energy usage at the hütte and to design a robust off-grid system that they could depend on at such remote and high altitude. Meisl Elektro-Mechanik is a family-run business that's been operating locally for more than 30 years.
The owner and the housekeeper of the hut were asking us why the runtime of the generator increased so much the last few years, which is of course not great because the housekeeper has to pay a lot for the fuel, which is also a problem for the old inverters because the peak load increased a lot, so they couldn't turn on everything at the same time. While for the new batteries, the lithium batteries, maybe the capacity in the future will sink, however they will still have an efficiency of almost 100% for the batteries, minus the efficiency of the inverters.
The first step was to install a Smart One energy management system and energy meters to measure the power usage and relay it online to the cloud. It extensively measured energy into the old batteries and how much of that was being discharged to gauge their efficiency. This came out at around 50%, which was far from optimal moving forward.
They didn't expect that the efficiency of the battery was already that low, but they could see that actually, and we showed them the data of the Smart One, and then they totally agreed that they need a new battery. And in a few weeks, they will see that this was the right decision because we are very sure that runtime of the generator will be lower than last year.
With all the data taken on board, Meisl designed a brand new energy system. This will replace the previous system in the electric room in the basement. There are 6 48-volt Sagasa EBIC 280 amp hour batteries wired into a new DC cabinet. The total power from these lithium iron phosphate batteries is 80.6 kilowatt hours. There are 3 48 volt 15 kVA Victron Energy MultiPluss-IIs wired in 3-phase. There is a new AC cabinet for the property. Meisl pre-made the complete system, including wiring and software updates, at their workshop at Berchtesgaden. With installations at remote locations like this property, you can't exactly pop out and buy a bit of cable.
They don't have the time to think about all to how to program a system, which adapters are needed. So we are all doing this work before.
Several solar panels previously installed on the roof will continue to use SMA solar charge controllers. The Meisl team increased the solar on the roof by adding 31 new 325-watt panels from Kyoto Solar. These panels have thicker aluminium side supports, making them ideal for alpine snowy regions. These panels are fed into a new Fronius Simo advanced solar charge controller, mounted near to the electricity room, next to the large heated water tank. It was important to add new PV panels to the system, as readings taken of the old solar setups on site showed the load far outstripped the energy they were generating. The new PV system now generates an extra 10 kilowatts of power, but extra care is taken when installing PV panels in this part of Europe.
The snow weight will be a lot higher than in different countries here. In Germany and Austria, you always have to look on the weight, which might lie on the modules. We don't know a lot of manufacturers which have such a quality, but the ones who have this quality are more and more expensive than Victron. So Victron has the perfect price and quality. There can be connected a lot more batteries than the 6 right now. The system can be extended to 16 batteries altogether if it's needed. And it doesn't matter if this is right now, so they can extend it in a few years. We have chosen the Sigasa batteries. Sigasa provides a great support, and it's also a battery which can be recycled by 100%. Furthermore, lithium iron phosphate batteries have a high efficiency, which is also necessary for us. The old batteries were weighing altogether up to 6,000 kilograms, while the 6 new batteries weighing 600.
Some large items, like all the units and equipment and tools for this installation, have to be delivered by helicopter. But Michael also relies heavily on an electric cable car to deliver fresh produce and consumables every other day to keep down costs. This too is powered by the on-site system.
The cable car has a motor which can need up to 13 kilowatts, depending, of course, of the weight in the cable car and the speed the cable car travels. Which makes it complicated with the cable car is that when the motor starts, it has a high peak load, which needs to be provided by the battery or the generator. In the past, the cable car could only be driven if the generator was supporting the system. Now with the new system, we have a higher peak load, and the cable car can be driven just by the battery without the generator.
And have you tested it?
Yes, we have tested that yesterday. When some things were going down by the cable car, we tried it with the maximum load in the cable car, and we were starting it as fast as possible. So it needs a really high peak load, and this could be powered by the battery easily.
With the Berchtesgaden National Park welcoming around 1.5 million visitors each year, Michael and his hard-working team will be very busy in the coming summer seasons. At least they can be confident that the installed Victron energy system will keep them and their guests warm and safe, whatever the mountain weather throws at them. And if you'd like to learn more about how Victron Energy has positively intervened in other catering businesses, check out this video of a rather unique floating restaurant, which has benefited hugely from going off-grid after having a Victron Energy system installed.